All right, let's look at this tweet that Hillary Clinton just put out. It says, Trump speaking about outsourcing right now. Here's one of his shirts, made in Bangladesh. This is in line with what she said, other products. His ties were made in China. Corey Lewandowski, how do you respond?
Look, Trump the businessman is somebody who wants to make sure that he had an obligation to his family and his business to make the best profits available, and that's different than Trump the president. What he's talking about now is bringing American jobs back. And it's very different when you're in the private sector. When you're in the private sector, you have an obligation to your family and to your company to grow that company and provide good wages. And so if that opportunity was such where, you know, he had to go and find a product because he couldn't get it manufactured here in the United States, that's very different than being the chief executive officer of our country and bringing those manufacturing jobs back
here. But Corey, isn't his whole argument that he's a businessman, so he's going to do that as president?
Ali, go ahead. I want to hear what you have to say.
Yeah, Corey's whole point is that he's a businessman, so that's the experience he's going to use in his presidency. I want to point out a few inaccuracies in his speech. President Reagan was an absolute free trader who four times in 8 years brought in trade restrictions, and on all times they were temporary. The NAFTA agreement between Canada and Mexico was negotiated and put through by President George H.W. Bush. He tried to fast track it before his term ended on in January of 1993, and he couldn't do it in time, which is why Bill Clinton had to pick it up. And Bill Clinton added two side notes to that deal to add protections for U.S. workers. And his seven-point plan is a four-point plan because he divided China into 3 points, and he divided other trade manipulations into 2 points. So he wants to pull out of the TPP, which is, by the way, supported by the majority of Republican congressmen in Congress. So there are a lot of things about this that if this is the best speech Donald Trump has given, if it's indicative of the type of policy speech he's going to be delivering, we're in for a very boring 4 or 5 months, and people who check facts are going to be very, very busy.
Corey, I'll let you respond.
Look, here's the difference. Hillary Clinton has no plan. She supported the TPP 45 different times, and now all of a sudden the AFL-CIO is against it. Now she's trying to change her position and say she's always been against it. That's just not factually true. Her husband signed NAFTA. It's been a terrible trade deal. We've seen one-third of the jobs in Pennsylvania already shipped overseas. 69,000 jobs have gone by the wayside. 2 million jobs nationwide have gone by the wayside.
Because
since
of the productivity,
TPP,
Corey,
since the
Corey,
TPP
you know
has
that.
Come into play.
America
and the bottom line is Hillary Clinton continues to support a terrible deal for the American public.
CNN Money has done a great piece on manufacturing in America. It is up on every measure, as it is in Germany, as it is in China, because China at Foxconn uses robots to put your iPhone together.
The Economic Policy Institute has been very clear that 2 million jobs have been extracted.
But not because of Chinese manipulation, Corey. He's not wrong.
I want to also go to another point that Donald Trump made when it came to Hillary Clinton.